October 29th. 1038. Angeloth, Archbishop of Canterbury, died. He is noted for having refused to crown Harold, although he had enjoyed the patronage of his father Canute. 1268. Conradino, Emperor of Germany, beheaded at Naples, at the age of 16, in a hazardous attempt to recover a part of his possessions which had been wrested from him. He fell into the power of his enemy. 1618. Walter Raleigh, an illustrious English nobleman, beheaded at the age of 66. He is memorable as a statesman, seaman, soldier, chemist and chronologist. He obtained the patent of Virginia in 1584. 1666. James Shirley, an English dramatic writer, died. His death was occasioned by the Great Fire of London. Both himself and his wife died of fright, and were buried in one grave. He wrote 37 plays and a volume of poems. 1666. Edmund Calamy, an eminent English divine, died, it is said, by reason of the Great Fire at London. 1691. Melchizedek Thevenot died, librarian to the King of France, and a celebrated writer of travels. 1727. Earthquake in New England. No event of the kind had been witnessed by the English, of equal violence, since their settlement of the country, and consequently, they were greatly alarmed. It was felt along the coast 700 miles, though of only 2 minutes' duration, and the island of Martinique was in danger of being entirely destroyed by an earthquake the same day, which was felt at intervals during 11 hours. 1745. Battle of Freiburg. The Prussians under Prince Henry defeated the Allies, who lost 8,000 men. 1757. Edward Vernon, a renowned English admiral, died. 1776. The British and Hessians repulsed in an attack on the Americans under Colonel Glover, at White Plains. 1777. John Hancock resigned his office as President of Congress. 1777. The whole force of the Americans under Washington was 12,480 men, of whom 8,963 were regulars then called Continentals. 1778. Americans under Major Talbot captured the British schooner Pigot, and brought her into Stonington. 1783. John Lyrand d'Alembert, a distinguished French philosopher, died. 1792. Three of the mutineers of the ship Bounty were executed at Portsmouth. 1793. The Austrians under Clairfayt defeated the French in their entrenched camp before Mentz. The camp was carried, 106 cannon, 200 ammunition wagons, and 2,000 men were taken prisoners. 1795. The citizens of London obstructed the king on his way to the Parliament House, clamoring for bread, peace, no pit. A bullet pierced the glass of the king's coach. 1804. George Morland died, an exquisite English painter, principally of rustic scenes. 1810. Battle of Acapulco, Mexico. The Spanish patriots under the first Aldamo, defeated by the king's troops under Gin Calejas, with the loss of 6,000. 1812. Mallet, with 12 of his confederates in a plot to subvert the Bonaparte dynasty, were tried and shot in the plains of Greenhill. 1814. Holland, in consideration of its relinquishment of all its claims to the Cape of Good Hope, and to the colonies of Demerara, Escbo and Berbice, all the other colonies which she possessed previous to 1794, in Asia, Africa and America, were restored by Great Britain. 1814. Steam frigate Fulton launched at New York. 1814. The sloop of war Peacock, Captain Warrington, returned from a cruise of 147 days, during which she had captured and destroyed 14 British vessels. 1824. Charles Pinckney, an American orator and statesman, died. He was a patriot of the Revolution, and a member of the convention which framed the Constitution. 1825. The first boat on the Erie Canal, from Albany, reached Buffalo, on which occasion a celebration took place. 1828. Luke Hansard, a very eminent English printer, died. Distinguished also for his piety. 1831. Riots at Bristol, England, during which the jails were broken open and burnt, the mansion house and custom house destroyed, the toll gates pulled down, and many private houses plundered and set on fire, by which some hundreds of people were burned to death. 1841. Thomas Phillips, an eminent English vocalist, died by a railroad accident, aged 66. 1842. Alan Cunningham, an eminent Scottish poet, died in London, aged 56. 1850. The statue of John C. Calhoun, which had been lost by the wreck of a vessel, was recovered almost without injury. 1850. The Portuguese frigate Dona Maria, the second, of 32 guns, accidentally blown up in the harbor of Macau, and completely destroyed. Perished. 1852. The remains of Daniel Webster were buried at Marshfield, Massachusetts, many thousands of citizens of Boston and adjoining towns being present. 1854. Josiah Butler, an eminent New Hampshire statesman and judge, died at Deerfield, aged 74. 1854. W. W. Farmer, Lieutenant Governor of Louisiana, died at Baton Rouge, aged 45. For many years a prominent man in the state.